we're going to make the decision that putting a ventilated tube in the ear is the right thing to do. And you'll hear lots of different names: ear tubes, ventilation tubes, pressure equalization tubes, tympanostomy tubes. Basically, all those mean the same thing, which is a way of getting air into the middle ear. So the procedure itself is pretty brief. It takes about 10 minutes. My child typically will go to sleep with a mask only, not even an ear breathing tube, unless we're doing other procedures together with the tubes. And we're going to use an ear microscope. And that's just a way of magnifying the eardrum so I have a good look at all the landmarks there. Make a tiny incision. Whatever fluid is trapped behind the ear, the eardrum in the middle ear gets suctioned out at that time. And then replace this small ventilating tube. Place some antibiotic drops, and go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. Once these tubes are in place, basically this is a piece of plastic, it's a foreign body in the eardrum, and the eardrum is going to respond to that by trying to push it out. Now for most kids that process takes somewhere between 1 and 2 years, but the most unpredictable things about this process are how long it's going to take any one individual child to grow out of the need for tubes and have their own eustachian tube work better, and how long exactly that tube is going to stay in place. Since we don't know exactly how long any one tube is going to last, we do some routine maintenance visits about 6 weeks after the procedure to check the position, make sure they're open, and recheck the hearing, and about every 6 months thereafter until the tubes are out and the ears are clear.